All right, imagine this. You wake up one morning, stretch, grab your phone, and nothing. No messages, no emails, no notifications. Weird. You step outside. No cars, no people, no sounds except for the wind rustling through empty streets. At first, maybe you think, hey, this is kind of peaceful. No traffic, no awkward small talk, no endless meetings that could have been emails. But then it hits you, this isn't just a lazy Sunday morning. Every single human being on Earth gone. So what happens next? What does the world look like without us? Well, buckle up because nature's about to reclaim everything. The first few hours, the world forgets about you immediately. You'd think the Earth would at least take a moment to mourn us, right? Nope. Within hours of humans disappearing, the first signs of change would already be happening. Planes? Yeah, about 40,000 are in the air at any given time. And without pilots, autopilot systems would keep them cruising for a while, until they inevitably run out of fuel and plummet from the sky. Subways? Underground trains would grind to a halt as power stations start failing. Some cities might experience temporary backups from generators, but within hours, the world's electrical grid would start flickering out like a dying candle. And here's where things get really interesting: nuclear power plants. Without humans monitoring them, their automatic safety measures would shut them down at first. But without maintenance, within a few days or weeks, some of them would melt down and leak radiation into the atmosphere. Oh, and let's not forget, without us managing sewage systems, cities would start flooding with wastewater in less than 48 hours. Yep, your dream of a human-free utopia just turned into a dystopian sewage nightmare real fast. The first few days, lights out, chaos begins. By now, power grids across the world have collapsed. Cities go completely dark. If you somehow still had a flashlight and were wandering around, you'd notice something eerily beautiful. For the first time in centuries, the stars would be crystal clear over every major city. No more light pollution. But you wouldn't be admiring the night sky for long because animals are on the move. Without humans, domesticated animals are suddenly on their own. Cows, pigs, and dogs that relied on humans for food? Many would struggle, except for cats. Cats, let's be real, have always been plotting for a world without us. They'd go full predator mode, adapting almost immediately. Meanwhile, zoo animals? Well, without keepers to feed them, things would get messy. Some would break free, turning cities into real-life wildlife parks. Imagine walking through an abandoned London and spotting lions roaming Hyde Park or elephants stomping through Times Square. Nature doesn't just stop at animals. Plants start pushing through sidewalks, climbing over buildings, and slowly dismantling our cities one crack at a time. The first few months, the great takeover begins. At this point, nature is winning and it's not even close. Dams? Without humans maintaining them, many would burst or crumble, causing massive floods that reshape entire landscapes. Bridges and roads, once carefully maintained, start falling apart. One of the weirdest sights? Skyscrapers covered in vines, looking like something out of a post-apocalyptic movie. Places like Dubai, New York, and Tokyo, once symbols of human achievement, start crumbling into ruins. But here's the twist: not everything disappears immediately. Some human structures are weirdly resilient. Take the Hoover Dam, for example. It could last for thousands of years without humans. And certain satellites orbiting Earth? They'd keep transmitting signals for centuries before eventually breaking down. 100 years later, humanity? Never heard of it. Fast forward a century, and the Earth is unrecognizable. Forests have swallowed cities. Coastal towns have been washed away. Animals that were once endangered, thriving. In fact, places that were once polluted wastelands have started healing. The air is cleaner. The oceans are full of life again. The only real remnants of human civilization: ruined buildings, rusted out cars, and the occasional buried relic that nature hasn't erased yet. The pyramids? They might still be around. The Great Wall of China? Cracking, but still visible. But our most lasting legacy? Plastic. Yep, our plastic waste, the stuff we used once and threw away, would still be scattered across the planet, taking thousands of years to fully break down. Congratulations, future archaeologists. that's what we left behind. 10,000 years later, would anything remember us? Now, at this point, almost every trace of human civilization is gone. Even entire cities have been reclaimed by forests, lakes, and deserts. The only structures still standing, probably mountain-carved monuments like Mount Rushmore, since those are built to last. But would Earth even remember us? Would there be any evidence that we ever existed? The answer is, maybe. Some radio waves we've sent into space might still be traveling through the universe, faint echoes of our existence. But unless aliens happen to catch one and think, hey, let's go check that out, Earth would just move on without us. And honestly, it wouldn't even miss us. Well, if you were hoping for a world without humans to be a high-tech utopia, bad news, it would look a lot more like an abandoned jungle than a sci-fi paradise. But here's the thing, Earth wouldn't be destroyed without us. In fact, it would flourish. Wildlife would take over. The air would be cleaner. The oceans would recover. In a weird way, the planet would be better off. But the real question is, do we want to be remembered as a species that left behind a planet full of ruins and plastic? Or as one that actually took care of it while we were here? Because if we ever do disappear, Earth won't mourn us. It'll just keep spinning, as if we were never here at all. If you enjoyed this wild thought experiment, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next deep dive into absurd science. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.